Isa ka ba sa mga batang mahilig sa numbers? O isa ka sa mga natatakot at nahihirapang intindihin ang mga mathematical concepts? Huwag kang mag-alala! Nandito ako para tulungan ka! Ang mathematics ay gagawin nating easy, fun, and exciting with me, Teacher Joyce!
Lesson 24, Visualizing Addition and Subtraction of Similar Fractions. Objective: after going through this lesson, the learners are expected to visualize addition and subtraction of similar fractions. On our previous lesson, we have discussed that a fraction is a part of a whole. It represents one or more equal parts of a whole object. For example, we have a whole pizza. If we divide it into four equal parts, we can express the fraction as 4/4 or one whole. If we ate one part of the pizza, we can express the remaining pizza as 3/4, where the number above the line, which is 3, will serve as our numerator, and it indicates the number of equal parts to be considered. The line is called the fraction bar or division bar, and the number below the fraction bar represents the denominator. It indicates the total number of equal parts the whole is being divided. Let's take a look into this example. I have here a whole rectangle. We have divided the rectangle into 8 equal parts. 8 will be our denominator because it represents how many parts thus a whole rectangle is divided into. Then, if 4 parts of the rectangle were shaded blue, 4 will be our numerator, which represents the shaded part of the rectangle. So we have 4/8 as our fraction. So we have another rectangle, and it is also divided into 8 equal parts, and that will serve as our denominator. 3 parts is shaded blue, which represent as our numerator. The fraction can be expressed as 3/8. Let's solve 4/8 plus 3/8 equals. First step is to take a look on the denominator. As you can see, both of the fractions have 8 as their denominator. Fraction with the same denominator is what we call similar fraction. To add or subtract similar fraction, we can just simply copy the denominator. So we write 8 on the denominator, then only the numerator are the ones that we will solve. So we have 4 plus 3 is equals to 7. So the answer is 7/8. Remember to express your answer in lowest term. As a review, a fraction is in its lowest term or simplest form when its numerator and denominator have no common factor other than 1. Since 7 and 8 have no common factor aside from 1, 7/8 is in the lowest term. Let's have another example. We have here two figures. The first figure says 8 parts is shaded, and the whole circle is divided into 16 parts. So our fraction can be expressed as 8/16. Next, another figure says 4 parts are shaded, and the whole circle is divided into 16 equal parts. Our fraction can be represented as 4/16. Let's solve 8/16 plus 4/16 is equal to, first is to add the numerator, 8 plus 4 is 12. Then copy the denominator, which is 16. 12/16 is not in the lowest term. So to change it in its lowest term, we need to get the greatest common factors of 12 and 16. Factors of 12 are 1 times 12, 3 times 4, and 6 times 2. Let's arrange this from least to greatest. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. While the factors of 16 are 1 times 16, 8 times 2, and 4 times 4. If we arrange the factors from least to greatest, the factors are 1, 2, 4, 8, and 16. The common factors is 1, 2, and 4. And the greatest common factor is 4. Now, we need to divide both the numerator and the denominator to 4. 12 divided by 4 is 3. And 16 divided by 4 is 4. Our answer would be 3/4. This time, let's try to solve without the figure. So we have 3/4 minus 2/4. Let's first solve for the numerator. 3 minus 2 is equals to 1. Then we will just simply copy the denominator, which is 4. As you can see, 1/4 is in the lowest term, since both of its numerator and denominator have no common factor other than 1. Now, it's your time to solve. In 3 minutes, I want you to add or subtract the given similar fractions. Don't forget to express your answer in lowest term. Your timer starts now. Thank you. Time's up! Let's check your work. 6 + 12 + 3 = 12 = 2. First, we add the numerator. 6 + 3 = 9. Then we will just simply copy the denominator, which is 12. The answer is 9 = 12. 9 = 12 is not in the lowest term. So to change it into its lowest term, we need to get the greatest common factor of 9 and 12. Let's write the factors of 9. So we have 1 times 9 and 3 times 3. Factors are 1, 3, and 9. Well, the factors of 12 are 1 times 12, 3 times 4, and 6 times 2. Or 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. Their common factors is 1 and 3, and the greatest common factor is 3. Now, we need to divide both the numbers and the denominator to 3. 9 divided by 3 is 3, and 12 divided by 3 is 4. Our answer would be 3/4. For number 2, we have 8/8 - 5/8 = 2. First is to solve for the numerator. 8 - 5 = 3. And then we will just simply copy the denominator, which is 8, since both of the fractions are similar. This time, 3/8 is in its lowest term, since both of the numerator and the denominator have no common factor other than 1. Did you get the correct answer? Excellent! That's all for today. If you learned from this video, don't forget to enroll for my channel by hitting the subscribe button and the notification bell for more videos. Once again, this is your teacher Joy saying, ang mahirap na math problems ay kaya nating padaliin. Bye-bye and have a great day!